it's Jen. I'm going to be talking about my favorite items from last month. So I have been traveling a lot from Oakland to Los Angeles to film for The Get Up these past few months, but December was the most grueling because this time I went 3 times. But one item that really saved my butt was this Army Surplus travel bag, and it just carried all of my carry-on essentials. It's got a first aid decal, which gives off a vibe of urgency and importance to all my products. And I love how large it is and how it fits everything inside, even items that aren't airplane friendly. It's lined with this plastic, so if there was an instance where something exploded, it ain't a big deal. I'll just wipe it and be done with it. It's been really cold and I've been loving to just kind of slip into my fuzzy cardigan. And because the texture is really thick and really dense, it's just extremely warm. I wear this cardigan just out and about or just chilling in my house sometimes when it gets really cold. And sometimes it just stays on my lap like a little animal and I just pet it and I use it as a blanket because it's so soft. I have been obsessed with Sex and the City, and I know I'm really late to the bandwagon, probably a decade, but I saw it on my HBO Go account and there were all the seasons right there and I was bored. And I just got sucked into the vortex of Sex and the City. It is so freaking good and very, very addicting. I feel like the show just makes me really excited for my 30s. And each episode has a theme about love and relationships. I'm currently on season 5 right now and I'm kind of freaking out because there's only, I guess, 1 season left, but season 6 is divided into 2 parts. So after this, I just don't know what I'm gonna watch anymore. All my current shows I've been watching have ended. Breaking Bad is done, Boardwalk Empire is on break right now, and Game of Thrones hasn't come on either, so I am just kind of in a rut, so leave me a comment with your recommendation. Last month, I finished a book called Invisible Monsters by Chuck Palahniuk, and I ended up getting the remix version of the book because it was the only thing that was sold at the bookstore that I went to, and plus, the cover looked pretty cool. This novel is definitely not your typical run-of-the-mill story. It's jacked up and it's extremely graphic. It's about a model who was basically living the dream, one of the most beautiful creatures on the planet, and then suddenly a bullet comes through her car and she becomes extremely deformed. Like half of her face is gone now and she can't talk and she has to communicate through writing. And I personally love the remix version because time isn't linear with this book. It jumps from chapter to chapter and I feel like this format mirrors memories that we have in our brain. Because when you look back, you don't look at memories in a chronological order, they're just kind of random, at least for me and my brain. I've got a film recommendation, it's called Her and it's in theaters now. It's about a quirky modern love story about a man who falls in love with his computer operating system. She's kind of like Siri, but 100 times cooler. And Scarlett Johansson is the voice, and oh my god, can I just say that I fell in love with her too. Spike Jonze did an amazing job with the storyline, and I think he captured scenes so beautifully by utilizing lens flares right. Like, everything just felt like a really crystal clear dream, which was nice. Lately, I have been really careless with my caffeine intake, probably because I have all these cute little coffee packets from World Market that I got as a Christmas gift. It's made me even more of a coffee junkie because I have been really excited to try out all the different flavors and experiencing the different tastes. It's just been a really exciting way to jumpstart my morning. Anyway, those were all my December favorites. I'm still debating whether I want to do a 2013 year recap video, but I'm not sure if anyone is interested in it because I feel like you can just rewatch my old videos that I made last year and relive it that way, but I don't know. I'm still thinking about it. You can find me on Twitter and Instagram at I'm Jen M, and I'll see you next one. Bye everyone!